Joyce DeWitt is a well-liked TV actress, best known for her incredible portrayal of the character Janet Wood in the ABC sitcom Three's Company. She spent a little over 7 years as one of the main cast members of the show and proved to be a real gift to the show and its audiences. After her exit from the hit series, she continued to act in various films and TV series. But what exactly happened to this actress and her career? In this video, we're going to check out everything there is to know about Joyce, her past and present life, and how she abruptly ended her acting career. But is it officially over? Apart from her emblematic role in Three's Company, Joyce has taken part in multiple films and TV shows. Her acting debut came in the mid-70s series Beretta, where she had a small supporting role. After Three's Company ended, she was very active and worked in many productions. Some of her popular recurring roles were in the series The Ropers, The Love Boat, and Sybil. Who is Joyce DeWitt? Joyce was born April 23, 1949, in Wheeling, West Virginia. She's the daughter of Paul and Norma DeWitt and has three older siblings, two brothers named Douglas and David, and one sister, Ruth. Joyce's family moved when she was 5 years old to the town of Speedway, Indiana, a northern suburb of Indianapolis. She began her acting career at 13, taking part in various ads for food, clothing, and shoes. In the 60s, Joyce ventured into theater plays and productions. Despite the many rumors on the internet, she was never mentored by actor Abe Vigoda, and the two never even met. In 1975, the young actress landed her first role on TV in Beretta. That same year, she also starred in Most Wanted. Even though these were small, supporting roles, they helped her launch her career, becoming a main cast member of Three's Company. Joyce DeWitt gained international popularity in 1977 after joining the show Three's Company. The sitcom aired on ABC from March of 1977 to September of 1984. In the series, Joyce began rooming with other rising stars in the film industry, Suzanne Summers and John Ritter. The show focused on the three main cast members who were residents of the fictional apartment 201 in Santa Monica, California. Everything was going well until the cast experienced a falling out and Joyce felt betrayed and left out by her colleagues. Janet Wood instantly became a fan favorite thanks to her spunky personality, funky style, and especially because of her eye for pretty things. During her tenure on the show, she worked and managed the arcade flower shop. Janet was portrayed as the intelligent, reliable, and responsible roommate, as opposed to her ditzy blonde counterpart, Chrissy. The florist brought a calmness to the always buzzing and chaotic apartment that she shared with Jack and Chrissy. But just like many successful projects, this one included a lot of controversy. The main controversy surrounding the show was Suzanne Summers, because of whom the cast experienced a huge falling out. Summers disputed her pay in the early 1980s, especially after her character became a media icon and elevated her to a rich television superstar. She questioned her salary, expecting to receive equal or greater earnings than that of John Ritter, the main male star of the show. To prove the difference in question, by the fifth season of Three's Company, Summers was receiving $30,000 an episode, while Ritter was earning $150,000 an episode. Eventually, after multiple protests and fights, she and the show parted ways. After she left the show, Summers' character was replaced by her fictional cousin, Cindy Snow. The departure caused a rift between all three castmates, and despite being media sensations, they didn't communicate with each other. Luckily, Suzanne was able to reconnect with John Ritter before he sadly passed away. A few years later, she rebuilt the connection between herself and Joyce DeWitt through her online show Breaking Through. In addition to these differences, there was also another thing that caused deception between Joyce and John Ritter, the creation of the spin-off titled Three's a Crowd. When Three's Company was coming to an end, it was revealed the directors and producers were working on a spin-off. To the surprise of its fans, the spin-off included only Jack Ritter's character and said nothing about his former roommates, Chrissy or Janet. It was reported via numerous sources that DeWitt felt betrayed and left out for not being given a role. It was also heartbreaking for her to find out about this from Vicki Crawford, who played the role of Mary Carteret and whose character was introduced at the end of Three's Company. The spin-off continuation aired on ABC immediately after the finale of Three's Company, and, as expected, it didn't do well in the ratings. It was canceled after a season. If you're enjoying this video so far, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Click the bell icon to stay updated on our latest content. After Three's Company. In the early 80s, after the show's conclusion, Joyce had a brief role in an episode of Finder of Lost Dove. She was later given an opportunity to star in this and other shows such as The Rappers, All in the Family, Maude, and She's the Sheriff. Ultimately, due to a lot of issues in her personal life, the TV star decided to quit acting acting for several years. She resumed acting in June of 1991, taking part in the production of Noises Off at the Cherry County Playhouse in Michigan. A few years later, she returned to TV and appeared in the comedy film Spring Fling. In the late years of the century, the actress had a small role in the CBS sitcom Sybil, followed by two appearances on Living Single and Twitch City as herself. DeWitt started the new millennium with several guest appearances on The First 50 Years and The Truth Behind the Sitcom Scandals, where she was asked about working with Suzanne Somers and John Ritter. She was interviewed about her experience on the classic sitcom, the drama between her and her castmates, and what it felt like to finally rise to popularity. Around the same time, she performed in Hope Island and the Nick at Night Holiday Special. Starting in the 2000s, she's mostly been appearing on reality shows, television specials, and documentaries rather than films or TV series. In 2003, she made her debut as a producer in the film Behind the Camera, the unauthorized and untold story of Three's Company. She also hosted it. The NBC documentary followed the success of the sitcom and the interpersonal conflicts that occurred among the cast and staff. Melanie Paxson was chosen to portray Joyce DeWitt. Through the past two decades, Joyce occasionally starred in films and TV series. Her most notable appearances were in the feature films Call of the Wild, Falling Better Now, Snapshot, and My Boyfriend's Dog. She also returned to the theater, performing in several plays such as Miss Abigail's Guide to Dating, Dinner with Friends, and Love Letters. DeWitt has also been consistently doing charity work. Her charity work includes hosting presentations for the Hollywood Family Assistance Program, the International Awards Ceremony at the White House, and the World Food Day Gala alongside Jeff Bridges. In many people's eyes, Joyce was considered a star, especially after her highly praised work on Three's Company. However, quitting acting played an important role in her downfall. How do you feel about Joyce DeWitt? Do you think she could have saved Three's a crowd by being included in the cast? Let us know in the comments section below. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure you click the like button and subscribe to Facts First if you haven't already.